event since I've arrived in Nigeria 3 months ago. On behalf of my wife Ayelet, who is sitting here on myself, I would like to thank the organizer that you have invited us and you have given us the honor and the privilege to come here today and to bring greetings on behalf of the State of Israel. The late Yitzhak Rabin symbolized the State of Israel. On the year 1948, when Israel was just born, when Yitzhak Rabin was only 26 years old, he was a commander of the Brigade Harel, who fought to defend Jerusalem, the capital of Israel that was just born, the holy city of Jerusalem, the city that is holy for Christians, for Muslims, and of course, for Jews. On the year 1967, when Yuval and myself, I think we both, Yuval, were bar mitzvah, in the year 1967, Yitzhak Rabin led Israel as the chief of staff of the Israeli army to its greatest victory in the Six Days War. Israel was in a period of alert and Israel became victorious. Yitzhak Rabin, who knew maybe more than anyone else the price of wars, being the Prime Minister of Israel on 93, led us for peace with the Palestinians when he signed the Oslo Accords in the White House on September 93 with President Clinton and Arafat, and on October 94 with King Hussein of Jordan in the Arava near Eilat in Israel. I was privileged to be there as a coordinator of peace accords with Jordan, as I told Yuval. And for this, he was awarded on December 94 with the Nobel Peace Prize. Madam First Lady, Mr. Yuval Rabin, your presence here today is symbolizing the deep connection between Israel and Nigeria. The deep connection between Israel and Nigeria. The common values, the common goals, the common aspiration for peace. There's nothing like the vivid persona and the memory of Yitzhak Rabin to symbolize this aspiration. On behalf of the State of Israel, I would like to thank all the participants in building this great school. Am Yisrael Chai. Long live Nigeria and Israel.
Of the executive. Stays on land. Okay, name three.